Today, our topic of discussion is DNA replication in prokaryotes. The objectives are, now, what is DNA replication? DNA replication is the process whereby DNA makes a copy of itself before cell division. Before going in details how DNA is copied, we have to discuss some main headings. For example, types of replication, direction of replication, and enzymes involved in DNA replication. Now, we will discuss them one by one. Number one, types of replication. Three modes of DNA replication have been reported so far. First, semi-conservative replication. Second, conservative replication. And third, dispersive replication. Now, semi-conservative DNA replication. Two strands of the original DNA is separated and each is duplicated by the synthesis of the complementary strand, thus producing two exact replica of the parent DNA. Each of the two molecules thus contains one original strand and one newly synthesized strand. Thus, only one of the two strands of the original DNA is conserved. This mode of replication is known as semi-conservative mode of replication. Second is conservative DNA replication. When complementary polynucleotide chains are synthesized and an exact replica of the parental DNA is formed, but the two newly created strands then come together and the parental strand reassociates, the original helix is conserved. Number third, dispersive replication. Here the parental strand are dispersed into two newly double helix following replication. Hence, each strand consists of both old and new DNA. This mode will involve cleavage of the parental strands during replication. It is most complex of the three possibilities and is therefore considered to be least likely to occur. Number two, unidirectional and bidirectional DNA replication. According to John Cairns, the DNA synthesis starts at a fixed point on the chromosome and proceeds in one direction. It was subsequently realized that Cairns' results could be interpreted in terms of bidirectional replication also. Additional evidence supporting bidirectional replication were obtained from autoradiography, electron microscopy, and genetic studies. In view of the above evidences, it is now known that DNA replication can be unidirectional or bidirectional, depending upon whether the replication from the point of origin proceeds only in one direction or proceeds in both the directions. A replication I may appear in both the situations, unless the replication starts from one of the two ends of a linear DNA molecule. However, in unidirectional replication, one of the two ends of the replication I will be stationary and the other end will move with the replication. On the other hand, in bidirectional replication, none of the two ends will be stationary and both will be moving. Number three, enzymes involved in DNA replication. The enzymes involved in DNA replication are DNA polymerase, DNA gyrase, DNA ligase, helicase, primase. Now, we will discuss them one by one. DNA polymerase. The primary enzyme which carries out the condensation of the nucleotides to form a polynucleotide chain is the DNA polymerase. It is a single polypeptide with a molecular weight of 109 kd. It catalyzes the synthesis of the DNA from 5 prime to 3 prime direction. That is, starts copying the template DNA from its 3 prime end. It cannot act in opposite direction. DNA polymerase has three distinct properties. Number one, one of the important function of DNA polymerase is 5 prime, 3 prime polymerase activity, which is the predominant function of the enzyme and is responsible for the nucleotide to form the DNA chain. A new nucleotide is added to an existing oligonucleotide at the 3 prime OH group. For the formation of a new strand, a single strand DNA is required, which is to be copied and is known as template. The enzyme thus depends on a template DNA and is referred as the DNA-dependent DNA polymerase. Number two, another function of DNA polymerase is 5 prime, 3 prime exonuclease activity, which helps in the removal of nucleotides from the DNA chain. RNA primer is removed from the newly synthesized chain by 5 prime, 3 prime exonuclease activity. Number 3, DNA polymerase shows another function of 3 prime, 5 prime exonuclease activity, which catalyzes the removal of nucleotides from the 3 prime end of the DNA chain. Arthur Korenberg was the first scientist who discovered the DNA polymerase and thought that it is the only DNA polymerase found in the cells which has polymerization activity. After that, various enzymes have been discovered with the similar activity as that of the Korenberg's enzyme. Korenberg's enzyme was designated as polymerase 1 or Pol 1. Later on, it was proved that Pol 1 is not involved in DNA synthesis. Then Pol 2 and Pol 3 came into picture. Let us discuss them one by one. DNA polymerase 1. DNA polymerase 1 was the first enzyme suggested to be involved in DNA replication. The enzyme is now considered to be a DNA repair enzyme and has 5 active sites. The enzyme is mainly involved in removing RNA primers from Okazaki fragments and fills up the gap due to its 5 prime, 3 prime polymerizing activity. The important function of this enzyme is proofreading, which includes polymerizing activity and exonuclease activity. DNA polymerase 1 consists of two fragments. Number 1, a larger fragment called Kleinow fragment, which contains 3 prime, 5 prime exonuclease activity with 5 prime, 3 prime polymerizing activity, and number 2, a smaller fragment which contains 5 prime, 3 prime exonuclease activity. DNA polymerase 2. DNA polymerase 2 resembles DNA polymerase 1 in its activity to bring about growth in 5 prime, 3 prime direction using free 3 prime OH groups, but mainly uses duplexes with short gaps only. It cannot use nicked duplexes, although it has 3 prime, 5 prime exonuclease activity. It lacks 5 prime, 3 prime exonuclease activity. DNA is not the replication enzyme and is involved in DNA repair. DNA polymerase 3. DNA polymerase 3 is a heteromultimeric enzyme with a molecular mass of about 900 kD in its complex or hollow enzyme form. The core polymerase that has catalytic activity consists of three subunits of alpha subunit has 5 prime, 3 prime synthetic activity, eta subunit has 3 prime, 5 prime exonuclease activity, and theta subunit is stimulator of the 3 prime, 5 prime exonuclease activity. The core enzyme, which has the ability to synthesize DNA, consists of subunits alpha, beta, and theta. The ta subunit is responsible for dimerization of catalytic core and increased activity. The catalytic core synthesizes rather short DNA strands because of its tendency to fall off the DNA template. In order to synthesize the long DNA molecules present in chromosomes. This frequent dissociation of the polymerase from the template must be eliminated. For this purpose, two homodimers of the beta subunit provides the ring structure that encircles the replicating DNA molecule and allows DNA polymerase 3 to slide along the DNA while remaining tethered to it. The DNA polymerase 3 hollow enzyme, which is responsible for the synthesis of both nascent DNA strands at a replication fork, contains at least 20 polypeptides. The structural complexity of the DNA polymerase 3 hollow enzyme shows 16 of the best characterized polypeptides encoding by 7 different genes. DNA gyrase or topoisomerase. Two strands of a double-stranded DNA are wound with each other in a spiral manner. Further, the DNA molecule is supercoiled under normal cellular conditions. It is therefore necessary to unwind the DNA so that the two strands can be opened to form single-stranded regions during the DNA replication. In order to get the DNA strands unwound, it will require to rotate at a speed of about 4500 RPM. The rotation will require a large amount of energy. The rotation of long strands of DNA at such a high speed can also cause mechanical shearing of the DNA. Thus, the entire process will create an undesirable conditions for the cell. This problem is tackled by the enzyme topoisomerase, which opens the coil turns by creating a small nick in one strand, letting the molecule uncoil by one turn and closing the gap. The topoisomerases are of two types. Number one, DNA topoisomerase 1 enzyme produces temporary single-stranded break or nick in DNA. And number two, DNA topoisomerase 2 enzyme produces transient double-stranded break in DNA. Type 1 topoisomerase are remarkable in that they don't require ATP to work. They bind covalently to the cut DNA strand, storing the chemical energy of the phosphodiester bridge, which they then use to reseal the strand after the tension has been removed from the DNA. An important result of this difference is that topoisomerase 1 activities remove supercoils from DNA one at a time, whereas topoisomerase 2 enzyme remove and introduce supercoils two at a time. The best characterized type 2 topoisomerase is an enzyme named DNA gyrase in E. coli. Gyrases or topoisomerase 2 is a tetramer with two alpha subunits encoded by the gene gyrase A and two beta subunits encoded by gene gyrase B. DNA ligase. It can join two pieces of DNA by the formation of a phosphodiester bond between these molecules. For this, the two DNAs should have a free groups at 3' and 5' ends respectively. It should be noted that the DNA ligase can only close a nick but cannot incorporate any new nucleotide to fill the gap. The enzyme is used to join the polypeptide fragments in the lagging strand during the DNA replication. DNA ligase catalyzes the covalent closure of nicks in DNA molecules by using energy from NAD, nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide, or ATP, adenosine triphosphate. Helicase. The enzyme, also referred as unwinding proteins, it is responsible for the melting of DNA and formation of single-stranded DNA at the beginning of the replication fork. The major DNA replicative helicase in E. coli is the product of DNA B gene. DNA helicase unwind DNA molecules using energy derived from ATP. The active form of helicase is the homohexamer of a 330 kd protein, primase. It is a specific RNA polymerase which is responsible for the synthesis of a sequence specific RNA molecule which serves as the primer to initiate the DNA synthesis. This is a monomer of 66 kd and is the product of the gene DNAG. This enzyme is simpler and much smaller than the RNA polymerase involved in the transcription and is distinct from it. Now, we will discuss process of DNA replication. The synthesis of DNA starts at a defined locus in the genome, which is known as the origin of replication. There are no known conserved sequences to define the origin of replication. Prokaryotes have only one origin of replication instead of eukaryotes, which has got multiple origins of replication. The origin of replication in E. coli genome has been well characterized. It is referred as RAC and it consists of 245 base pairs characterized by repeating sequences of 9 and 13 bases. The sequences at the origin of replication are found adenine thymine rich, which makes the melting of double-stranded DNA easier. The origins of replication in yeast are referred as autonomous replicating sequences, ARS. However, the origins from higher organisms have not been well identified. A unique sequence at which replication is initiated with the formation of a localized region of strand separation called the replication bubble. The formation of this replication bubble is due to the interaction of pre-priming proteins with RAC. A particular 82 kd protein called DNA A, encoded by gene DNA A, is responsible for the initial step of unwinding of helix. DNA A proteins bind cooperatively to form a core of 20 to 40 polypeptides with RAC DNA wound on the surface of the protein complex. Strand separation begins within the 3 tandem 13 base pair repeats in RAC and spreads until the replication bubble is created. A complex of DNA B protein and DNA C protein joins the insertion complex and contributes to the formation of the two bidirectional replication forks. The DNA T protein also is present in the pre-priming protein complex, but its function is unknown. Other proteins associated with the initiation complex at RAC are DNA J protein, DNA K protein, PRI A protein, PRI B protein, PRI C protein, DNA binding proteins, DNA gyrase, and single-stranded DNA binding proteins. The single-stranded character of the replication fork is maintained by the binding of single-strand specific DNA binding proteins referred as SSB proteins. The association of these proteins prevent the reformation of double-stranded DNA. The activity of DNA B is facilitated by the binding of another protein DNA C to DNA B. DNA B is present in form of a hexamer. There are 6 molecules of DNA C for each DNA B molecule. One monomer of DNA C binds to each of the subunit of the DNA B hexamer. Once the primer has initiated the DNA synthesis, DNA polymerase takes over and adds more nucleotides one at a time to the primer and continues to extend the DNA chain. Thus, a number of factors get associated to DNA to initiate the replication. This entire complex of DNA primase and DNA helicase is referred to as primosome. Once a replication fork has formed, the synthesis of new DNA strand is initiated by RNA primers synthesized by DNA primase. A single RNA primer is sufficient to the continuous replication of the leading strand. but the discontinuous replication of the lagging strand requires an RNA primer to start the synthesis of each Okazaki fragment. During the entire process, the helicase keeps binding ahead of the fork so that there is a forward movement of the fork. Now, the question arises, what is leading and lagging strands? The mechanism of the DNA replication explains the synthesis of DNA for one strand, namely 3 prime, 5 prime of template, which will be copied in the 5 prime, 3 prime direction by the DNA polymerase. How does the synthesis of the other strand, which apparently seems to grow in 3 prime, 5 prime direction, takes place? It was a big puzzle for a long time, as there was no known DNA polymerase which can carry out such an extension. This problem was solved in 1960s when Reggie Okazaki and his colleagues discovered the presence of a large number of small DNA fragments, each with an RNA primer attached to it, and was called as Okazaki fragments. It has been well established now that the synthesis of this strand also takes place only in the 5 prime, 3 prime direction. The primase initiates the synthesis of DNA at the 3 prime end of the opened region of the fork, and polymerase extends this primer towards the 5 prime side, synthesizing the new DNA in 5 prime, 3 prime direction. When more bases of template DNA opens up and the size of the fork is increased, a new primer is synthesized and gets annealed at the 5 prime end of the fork, and the entire process is repeated until the polymerase has reached to the first primer. The 5 prime, 3 prime exonuclease activity of Pol1 at this stage digests the RNA primer, and the polymerase fills the gap with DNA. Thus, the synthesis of this strand takes place in pieces. These pieces are then joined by DNA ligase to form a continuous DNA strand. There are separate primases for leading and lagging strands. The synthesis of two strands thus takes place in slightly different manner. One strand, which is known as the leading strand, is synthesized in a continuous manner, while the other strand, is called as lagging strand, is synthesized in discontinuous manner. The DNA replication is therefore semi-discontinuous in nature. The small fragments of DNA which are synthesized in the lagging strand are known as Okazaki fragments. It should be noted that there is a single primosome formation for the leading strand, while multiple primosomes are formed on the lagging strand. Each primosome results in the formation of a single Okazaki fragment. The insertion of Okazaki fragments on the lagging strand is carried out by primosome. The primosome gets energy from ATP to move along the DNA molecule. The unwinding of double helix takes place by the help of enzyme DNA helicase, and DNA primase synthesizes the RNA primers for successive Okazaki fragments. The RNA primers are covalently extended with deoxyribonucleotides by DNA polymerase 3. DNA topoisomerases provide transient break in the DNA that serves as sevals for DNA unwinding and keep the DNA untangled. Single-stranded DNA binding protein coats the unwound DNA and keeps it in an extended state for DNA polymerase 3. The RNA primers are replaced with DNA by DNA polymerase 1, and the single-stranded break left by polymerase are sealed by DNA ligase. The DNA is then condensed into the nucleoid or folded genome of E. coli, in part through negative supercoiling introduced by DNA gyrase. All of these enzymes and DNA binding proteins function in concert at each replication fork. The complete replication apparatus moving along the DNA molecule at a replication fork is called the replisome. The replisome contains the DNA polymerase 3 holoenzyme, one catalytic core replicates the leading strand. The second catalytic core replicates the lagging strand, and the primosome unwinds the parental DNA molecule and synthesizes the RNA primers needed for the discontinuous synthesis of the lagging strand. In order for the two catalytic cores for the polymerase 3 hollow enzyme to synthesize both the nascent leading and lagging strands, the lagging strand is thought to form a loop from the primosome to the second catalytic core of DNA polymerase 3. Now, we will discuss termination of DNA replication in prokaryotes. The E. coli chromosome carries a large termination zone, diametrically opposite to RSC, which blocks the progress of replication fork meeting at this region. E. coli chromosome and several plasmids carry specific sequences called termination sites, TER sites, TER sites, where TBP termination binding proteins or TUS proteins binds in the termination zone of E. coli. There are three termination sites, termination A, termination D, and termination E for counterclockwise fork, and three termination sites, termination B, termination C, and termination F for clockwise forks. These six sites are arranged in overlapping manner, leaving no replication-free gap on the chromosome. TBP and termination complexes formed at TER sites stalls the replication fork by inhibiting the DNA helicase or DNA B. When this termination zone is deleted, a replication stops simply by the meeting of opposite replication forks, suggesting that the termination zone is not essential. Dear students, this is all about DNA replication in prokaryotes.